leaves, of course, are just full of minerals and nutrients that they've worked hard getting out of the soil and concentrating. Well, instead of that all just falling on the ground and having to decompose and them having to capture it again and bring it up into the tree, they move a large amount of that out of the leaves before they fall on the ground. And a lot of those compounds that they break down to get the elements out, like nitrogen, for example, is chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll breaks down so they can remove all the iron and nitrogen, magnesium, and they move them back into the tree to get reused the following year. Great system. Well, for us, we're fortunate. It causes all these interesting, neat colors. So the green breaks down, and that reveals the yellow and oranges that have been there all along. We don't see them in the summer because there's so much green. It's like one drop of yellow, entire gallon of green paint. But then the green paint breaks down, you'd see the yellow. Now the red color, that actually forms in the fall of the year. And that's one that will vary more than the yellows and the oranges from year to year. The red pigments are actually sugar compounds that are built in the fall. So if we have dry conditions going into the fall, the trees are not photosynthesizing as much, they're not making as much sugar, and they won't have as much red pigment.